Thanks for checking out the second episode of Should You Read? And this one is for Should You Read Spider-Gwen? Okay, I got into this based off of my mainly my interest in the costume for Spider-Gwen. It's a phenomenal costume if you've seen it. The design that went into that was excellent. It's like a nice like white costume with like black highlights to show the spider webbing on it, and then it's got like some pink in certain key areas and a hood to it, and there's a little bit of like pink inside the hood with like some blue webbing in there. Super cool design, and that's kind of what drew me in. I also heard a lot of people saying that Spider-Gwen was really cool, so wanted to check it out. Read it on Comixology through their Unlimited service, and I got through two volumes because two volumes is what was available, so I think that ended up being something like 8 total issues, something like that. And obviously that's through Marvel. Marvel does Spider-Gwen, as most people would assume. So I've actually figured out through reading a bunch of comics through Comixology Unlimited that I'm not the biggest Marvel fan. I'm more of like, well, let me say, usually when you talk to like comic people, they'll kind of, you know, put you in a category and say, oh, you're more into Marvel comics, or you're more a DC type person, or you're more this, that, whatever. I'm more of an Image comic type person, I found, because the majority of the Image stuff that I found is what I like the most. Not to say that I don't like other stuff, I do. So that said, going back to Spider-Gwen, which is why we're here, should you read Spider-Gwen? I would say it depends. The story is interesting. The story is solid. And it was enough to keep me reading through the two volumes because it kept me interested. I really did want to know what was going on. I didn't feel fully connected to it as a story, but I think part of that is, well, two things. One, there was a lot of revamping of characters. So if you're already familiar with Marvel characters, very different. You know, like certain characters change genders. You know, there's some female characters that were male. That's not that big of a deal as, from that perspective, but it kind of like, when you already know something, it kind of like throws you off at first, and you're like, oh, okay. So you kind of have to refigure out who these characters are. Not only that, but there's some sort of storyline that took us to Spider-Gwen, where it's kind of like alternate realities. So some characters show up as they originally were, but they are different. Like, their role is different. Like, some people are, like, good guys when they used to be bad guys, and some guys are bad guys and they used to be good guys. So when you see these new characters, you see these old characters that you know about, you kind of don't know what their role is yet. And sometimes, if you don't know that going into it, for me it was kind of like, oh, this person's bad in this? Seems kind of weird to me. Or this person's good? That's weird. So I had a hard time getting over the hump of that through the first volume. Once I had that taken care of in the second volume, what really started to get me was it's very much geared towards like a teen audience, which I understand. You know, it's a new character. It's, you know, going towards a new generation because comic books need to continue to sell comics and they have to invest in their younger demographics to make sure that they can, you know, maintain. So I understand that. It's more towards a young base, but that's not to say that people who are in their older ages, like myself, I'm, you know, approaching 40, not to say that someone like me can't enjoy it. And like I said, I did enjoy it through the first two volumes. I just don't think I enjoyed it enough to purchase. That was kind of my thing, because after the first two volumes with Comixology, if you're doing the Unlimited, then you would have to purchase after that. It wasn't enough for me to want to purchase it. So the combination for me of a lot of the characters being a little and the, you know, it being very much geared towards teenagers kind of made me like, I don't need to buy this. I don't need to continue going, but I could see where a lot of people would like this. The other thing for me is the art isn't at the caliber that I would want for something that's Marvel. I usually think about Marvel and I think about really, really good artwork. And the artwork is a little more rough style. I know that's done intentionally sometimes, but for me it didn't come off all that great with what Spider-Gwen is. I wanted to see it drawn a lot cleaner, a lot more vibrant, and I guess not vibrant as far as like colors go, but like significantly more defined. I feel like a lot of stuff is a little more blurred with the artwork. And I just wanted it more like crisp and clean and like just super nice looking, and it wasn't super nice looking. It's just kind of like a tad more minimalistic in a sense. So, not a big, you know, I wasn't a huge fan of it. I won't be going back to it. But anyway, that said, because I want to keep these things relatively short, should you read Spider-Gwen? Yes, if you like what you heard in this video. I was kind of in the middle-ish. Overall, I think it's decent if you can get past the stuff that I was kind of having a little bit of trouble with. But on the Comixology 5-star scale, I gave it 3 stars. I think it's good for what it is and good for who it's aimed at. I just don't want to continue with it. The character is very cool and how the character came up and all that. So if it was written a little more mature, I would be way more interested and I'd probably continue to read it, but that's not what it is and that's okay. So anyway, hopefully this helped people out. If you have any recommendations for me, you want to see me do any videos for specific comics, let me know. If you want to see me do it for any shows, movies, stuff like that, we can do that too. Email me at brutalbattlepodcast@gmail.com, and brutal is BREWTAL. So brutalbattlepodcast@gmail.com. And until next time, keep it brutal.